Please join in, and we will be starting in 1 minute. All right, please join in. I will be doing a countdown and we shall be starting. So I will start 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're starting. You've seen this before. Okay, 4 people got this wrong. This is a frequently asked question. It's relevant for both tests. 1849 was when Groenland was created. Okay. And you're going to see this over and over again. So, people have got that wrong. Please get to know. So the question is, can a prime minister appoint a minister that is not a member of parliament? And the answer is yes. So the ministers do not have to be a member of parliament. However, ministers are usually members of parliament. 4 people got this wrong. This is a frequently asked question. So this is one of the questions that you have to know the answer to. So please get to know. Ricardo, Shelley, SS Robert, and DJ Mudassia is the highest climber up 19 places. Next one. You saw this in the previous test, so. All right, so 4 people got this wrong, and this kind of illustrates what I mentioned before. So as you can see, in the previous test, they asked about the right to expression. And in this one, they're asking about the right to create a forening. So make a list of all the rights that are protected in Groenland, because they could be asking about any one of those rights. Next one. Okay, so Ricardo, Arif, number 2, Shelley, number 3, Marjan, 4, and Robert, number 5. TCT is the highest climber, up 15 places.
Excellent.
Next one. Seen this before. All right, only one person got this wrong. The question is, who has the right to judge in Denmark? And that right belongs to the courts, okay? In Denmark, power is divided into 3 places, between the government, the parliament, and the courts. And you can see them here, government, parliament, and the courts. And the right to judge is resting with the courts, the power to judge, sorry, not the right, the power. All right, Ricardo still holding the number 1 spot, Shelley right behind him at number 2, Arif number 3, Robert and Marjan number 4 and 5, Masa Amini is the highest climber up 5 places.
Excellent.
Next one. The answer is yes. So if the Social Democratic Party wins a lot of votes this time, and the Red Bloc wins a lot of votes this time, then what's her name? That's Frederiksen could be prime minister yet again. So it's not like in the United States where one person can only be president one time if you serve 8 years. All right. Three players just reached down to a streak of three. Static top five. Moving on to the next one. This question has a double negative. So read it slowly and then answer. All right, so this is talking about minority governments. This is frequently asked. Six people got this wrong, so you need to know the answer to this question, okay? On to the next one. Three players just lost the answer streak of five. Sorry, guys. This is literally page one of the book. Chapter one, page one. I could tell who hasn't been reading and who hasn't been practicing. These two people that failed this. Please, okay, we're running out of time. You need to practice and you need to read. You can't get away from, practicing and reading. If you try to skip any of those, you're probably going to fail the exam. All right. Jewel is the highest climber, up nine places.
Excellent.
Next one. Frequently asked as well. Okay, seven people got this wrong. Anders Bevelsen, okay, started in Arif. I'm not sure that's right. In 1870, I think it's the Arbeiter Bevelsen. But anyways, Anders Bevelsen started in 1800, right? And what does it mean? So this is when farmers started forming cooperatives. So they decided to pool their resources and then purchase the units of production. So things like dairies, machines, whatever they needed to do their work. So they started cooperating with each other and found that that actually makes life easier for each of them rather than each person trying to do it by themselves. So that's what this is about. All right, moving on to the next one. Static top five. Okay, this is the most frequently asked question. Okay, so if there's any question that you need to know the answer to, it's this one. So the five people that got this wrong, please, please, you need to know the answer to this. Okay, so women got the right to vote in 1915. All right, so Ricardo, Shelley, Arif, Robert and TCT top five, 1 to 5. Three players just hit an answer streak of eight. Moving on to the next one. All right. I already gave you guys the answer to this. Read the question slowly. Read the question slowly. Okay. when I'm discussing anyways, Nina Bang, 1924. That's the answer to this. The question is, when did Denmark get its first female minister? Nina Bang, 1924. And that was when the Social Democrats won the parliamentary election and Thorvald Stauning became the first Social Democratic prime minister. He appointed her. Next one. The Panther has the highest answer streak of 10. That is a perfect score.
Perfect.
Moving on to the next one. We've seen this before. Okay, read the question slowly. It was asking about the number of communes in Denmark, not the number of members of parliament. Okay, so for the three people that got this wrong, I could see that you didn't read the question slow enough. Moving on to the next one. Alberto is making a comeback with 3 in a row and he's on fire.
Oh my, he's on fire.
Next one. I gave you the answer to this in the previous Kahoot. Let's see how well you guys do. Okay. I'm guessing Ricardo didn't read the question slowly, but anyways, make a list, okay? Please make a list of the responsibilities of the commune, responsibilities of the regions, and responsibilities of the state. Because as you can see, they ask about different ones on different questions. So it's good to know all of them. Ricardo dropped out of the top 5. He made a mistake and he's paying for it. Shelley is now at number 1. Mohammed, number 2. Arif, 3. TCT, 4. Robert, 5. Ash is back with an answer streak of 3. Round of applause. That was supposed to be a round of applause. Anyways, moving on to the next one. This question is now irrelevant. This question is now irrelevant. Okay, so Denmark used to have reservations with the EU in terms of working together for defense, but that changed. There was a referendum this year and those reservations were scrapped, and that was caused by the war in Ukraine. Moving on to the next one. Arif is now number 2. Mohammed dropped to number 3. TCT, 4. Robert, 5. Shelley holding the number 1. Mahsa Amini is back in the game. 3 in a row. Round of applause. There used to be this thing called the Amtan. I'm not sure if I'm saying it correct, but those were scrapped. The regions were formed and the number of communes were reduced to 28. Sorry, not 28, 98. Man, I'm tired. Anyways, moving on. NBI has a streak with 14 correct answers in a row. Round of applause. Read the question slowly. I gave you the answer to this. If you were listening, you'd get this right. Brenda it changed to 98. So number of communes used to be more than that, but it dropped to 98. All right. I mentioned this, all right. So this, it's asking about when did Denmark get its first social democratic prime minister? 1924, Thorvald Stauning. And this was also the year that Denmark got its first female minister, Nina Bang, also from the Social Democratic Party, appointed by Thorvald Stauning. All right, next one. Shelley, Arif, Mohammed, Robert, and DSB. About NATO and DK? I'm not sure what you're asking about. Oh, NATO. Yes, it changed this year. So there was a referendum on, I think it was the 1st of July. And everybody voted yes to scrap that reservation because of the war in Ukraine. Ricardo is making a comeback with three in a row and he's on fire. Oh my, he's on fire. Next one. Yes, so Rolf Trumper Bevelsen, so the Red Stocking Movement, which was a movement all over the world, also in Denmark, was working for gender equality. Okay, static top five, Ram has the highest answer streak of 16 and he's on fire. Frequently asked question. All right. He gets an explosion for this. Where is it? All right. Static top five, Mahsa Amini is back in the game with an answer streak of 3.
Excellent.
Next one. Okay, I need to emphasize this again. And the more I see numbers like this, the more I will emphasize this. I do know that I sound like a broken record, but it is for your own good. Okay, so please go to chapter 5. When you go to chapter 5, you make a list. That list should contain all the authors, musicians, basically any kind of creator. So that chapter is about all the creators, designers, artists, writers, musicians, everybody. Make a list. You put the person's name, the year they were active, and what they did. So what book they wrote, what songs they wrote, what paintings they had, what groups they were members of, all that stuff. Make that list. Because number one, frequently asked. Number two, when they ask new questions, it usually comes from that list. Okay, so please do that. I can see 28 people got this wrong. So I could tell that, you know, a disproportionate number of people haven't read that book. This is actually quite alarming. Please, please. All right, that was a complete reshuffle of the top five. RF is now number one, Mohammed number two, DSP number three, Dundio number four, and Khus A number five. Tough round, three players lost their answer streak of 3. Sorry, guys. Next one. All right. 1973. Not much to say there. Mohammed is now number one. Arif number two. DSB three. Dundio four. Kehus eight. Five. I think we are at the halfway mark now. All right, round of applause. Perfect. Nora has a streak with 20 correct answers in a row. That's a perfect score.
Excellent.
Frequently asked, one person got this wrong. Now you know what you don't know. Hopefully it was a mistake. And if it wasn't, now you know what you don't know. Tarzan is making a comeback with three in a row and he's on fire. Oh my, he's on fire. Frequently asked as well. Hopefully you all know this. All right, round of applause. TMR has a streak with 22 correct answers in a row.
Excellent.
Okay, so this is frequently asked. Kalmar Union was made up of Denmark, Sweden, and Norway. And sometimes they ask the question in a kind of twisted way where they say up until... So the Kalmar Union lasted about 300 years. But in the end, Sweden left because they had some kind of conflict with Denmark. And then the Kalmar Union was just between Denmark and Norway. So keep that in mind because there was a year, I think it was 2019, where the question was kind of asked in a different way. All right, next one. Okay. This question also showed up in Melbourne Escapes poem. This question is also very frequently asked. So for the two people that got this wrong, hopefully it was just a mistake. But if it wasn't, now you know what you don't know. Please get to know. Okay? You need to know the answer to this. Static top five. Faisal is back with an answer streak of three. And he's on fire. This is a tricky one. Let's see how you guys do on this. Okay, not so bad. 21 people got this wrong. This is a not so frequently asked question, but it has appeared in more than one test. this is about, because Greenland used to be a colony of Denmark, and gradually they were allowed independence. And Hjemstyre came into power in 1979. Although Greenland still depends on Denmark for defense. Next one. Four players just hit an answer streak of six. Okay, this is semi-frequently asked. In the 1980s, Denmark Radio lost its monopoly because a lot of other channels were created. So this is part of Denmark's media history. I could see actually more than half of you got this wrong. So please get to know this. It's semi-frequently asked, and it's super relevant for the next test. We're more than halfway through. Stat top five. Three players just hit an answer streak of 11.
Excellent.
Moving on to the next one. Yes, the Højskole ved Velsen, Grundtvig, NFS Grundtvig, very important. There's a whole section in the book on him. Brenda is making a comeback, three in a row. She's on fire. Frequently asked. Der et Undikland. Frequently asked. You need to know this. Okay? The three people that got this wrong, you need to know this. This is one of the questions that you have to know the answer to before you go in for the next test. Nora is back in the game. Three in a row.
Excellent.
All right, so Niels Bohr won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1922, and this year marks the 100th year anniversary of his Nobel Prize. So this is a frequently asked question, and there is a 100-year anniversary for his Nobel Prize, and that's relevant for current affairs under the theme of anniversaries. Marjan is back in the game with an answer streak of three. Round of applause. Okay, so in 1944, Iceland became completely independent of Denmark, and also in the same year, what's that guy's name? There was an author that won a Nobel Prize in Literature. Can't remember his name now. Something Jensen. Anyways, moving on. Nice. Sheher is back with an answer streak of three.
Excellent.
Next one. Yes, Johannes V. Jensen. Thanks, Arif. All right. So question about immigration to Denmark. This is frequently asked. I would suggest you go to that part of the book and make a list of the different time periods and who was immigrating to Denmark. Static top five. We're almost at the end of this. All right, so make a list of the political parties, their leaders, and the years that they were created. It's relevant for both the history and current affairs. Next one. Eight players have reached an answer streak of five.
Excellent.
Static top five still, Mohammed leading the pack. Ah, man, almost perfect scores. Two people got this wrong. Karen Blixen is Denmark's most important female writer. Next one. That is frequently asked, so please get to know that question. The two people that got it wrong. We talked about this several times. If you've been coming to the sessions, you should know this by now. All right, only one person got this wrong. Now you know what you don't know. Marine is back in the game, three in a row.
Perfect.
Last history question. Okay, the Social Democratic Party is connected to Arbeiderbevægelsen and employees basically historically have always voted for the Social Democrats. This is a frequently asked question. So please get to know this if you got this wrong. We're moving to current affairs. Static top five. This is November 2020. I do not expect you to know the answers to this. Pay attention to the themes we will be talking about and themes as we go through the questions. Pio is the highest climber up four places.
Excellent.
Okay, so this question, the theme is about state affairs. Okay, so what significant things have happened concerning the state? This year, the most significant thing has been the war in Ukraine, and Denmark has actually sent supplies, military supplies to Ukraine, and has also offered to train Ukrainian soldiers. So that's an example of something that's relevant for this year. Whether or not that's going to show up in the test, I do not know. But off the top of my head, that's one thing that's relevant for state affairs. I'm sure there's other things. And like I always say, I'm not the holy grail of current affairs. I just select topics and questions based on the recurring themes and the pattern I've seen over the years. All right. Shaji is making a comeback with 3 in a row.
Excellent.
All right, so the theme of this is political parties and their leaders. I've already asked you to make a list of all the political parties in parliament and their leaders, and also the years that they were created. That list will be relevant for current affairs and history. However, I'm not sure they're going to ask anything about leaders now because there's a parliamentary election. But I'd still suggest you make that list because it's relevant for history still. Next one. Brenda is making a comeback with 3 in a row, and she's on fire. Round of applause. All right, so state affairs yet again. This is talking about an agreement that the government made with many parties about the early pension, the right to early pension. State affairs, that's the theme of this. And off the top of my head, I'm not sure, have there been any recent agreements? Obviously, the one that was made that affected foreigners, which was about the, you know, what's that thing called? I can't remember, but Matthias Tesfaye was still Linnings Minister, which he's not now anyways. But yes, look out for any recent agreements that have been made. Yes, energy, and also the house, Huslier, what's that thing called in English? House rent, yes. So they put a ceiling on how much landlords can increase the rent. So keep an eye out. You can find all that stuff on the Folketing website and also the government website. So ft.dk and regering.dk. All right, moving on. 3 in a row, RZ is back in the game. Okay. So this was about the Me Too movement. Sophia Linde, a TV presenter, went on TV and called out someone that was working with her, I think her former boss. And yes, this is in the book now, but this is from November 2020. So it wasn't in the book then. And this is of the theme of this is some kind of scandal. And I think, I can't remember, but there was a question about a former mayor that lost his job because of a sexual assault scandal that he was facing. So this is in that theme. So the theme here is scandals, okay? So which scandals have happened within the last 6 months? So keep an eye out for those. All right, last one. Dundio on fire, 39 correct answers in a row. He's not number one. Number 3, he's on fire though. Oh my, he's on fire! Last question. Oh. I just gave you, yeah, this is a scandal. This is the guy I was talking about. And luckily, I didn't give you guys his name. Yes, Frank Jensen. All right. Theme here is scandal as well. Scandals. So within the last 6 months, have there been any scandals? Keep an eye out for that. Have a look through the news websites, newspapers. Ask your colleagues, you know, in case you don't check those things. And, you know, keep an eye out for scandals in the last 6 months because they're relevant. All right, podium time. Dundio, perfect score, number 3. Mohammed, 39. Number 2. Who's number 1? Oh, Arif. Arif with a perfect score. DSB and Ricardo, number 4 and 5.